Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's Sunday, June 26, 2016. And it's been a little bit of time, but that's okay. So let's get started. So we're working on a turn-based strategy. before I open up the project, we open up the previous project so you can see what we were basing on. Hey, Amir. Welcome to the chat. Thanks, Amir. Hey, welcome to the chat. Just so people know that if I see you in your chat, I'll probably say, you know, hi, welcome to the chat if I know as you come in. But I'm not going to say your name until you speak in chat, just in case you want to lurk, so. Yeah. So this was the older version that we're kind of fixing because it wouldn't upgrade to 4.12. There's a bunch of issues with it. Although it seems like some of the issues were actually more, because we're getting them again in a new project, so it might be actual Unreal Engine 4 bugs. But you know what it's like. It's like, is it an actual bug, or am I just an idiot, right? Interesting how it moved out of the way. But yeah, so it's like chess, except it's design levels, so you don't have an 8x8 grid necessarily. Some might work. But then when you kill the king, it removes the area control, so none of these guys can actually attack. As a matter of fact, I should have actually won right now, but I didn't have a win condition yet. So let's close it down and I'll show you the other version of it. So we're basically doing a third attempt at it, kind of. The first one was a game jam, which was just a nightmare, but this is what it used to look like. So that was version 2 I just showed you, kind of. Attempt 2, this is going to be attempt 1, whenever it loads. It's on a spinning drive, so it takes a while. The other ones are on SSD, but yeah. As you can see, this is a chessboard level. And you can select moves, you see the effects a bit different. You can move the queen up. And then you'll see the pawn can move any direction, but can eat on any diagonal, so I can make it with the queen, or the pawn, or can I make it eat with the queen? I'll make it eat with the queen. Then I'll eat you with the queen too, because lol. Okay. But that's the chessboard level. I said there's other levels. So this is gonna be more like I'm intending the actual game levels to look like when we're not talking about test maps. Here. I'm thinking of having a more of a less colorful art style for the levels, but you know. So in here, there's two knights over on the side here. I can either move my army up into town to get a good position in town. Meanwhile, the AI is gonna be moving into town too, if it wasn't so stupid. Or I could move my king to the side here, pick up one or both of the knights, and have one knight, but get, you know, into town in a medium pace, right? So I can move this knight now, but this knight's out of range. I can't do anything with it, but this one is, and so I can move this in. Or I can move it one further over. Now it's in range, so I can move it to any area here or there. So we're going to close this down. I could have just done close the solution and go back to start page, but this is about the same speed. And open the new project. Yay! This is what we're working on. And we're adding the player controller in to be able to, to be able to control the camera, but we haven't really finished that yet. We added the camera controls and the bind actions to it, and we added a bunch of methods to convert that into C++ variable changes. But it still doesn't actually have the logic behind it yet. That's what we're working on today. And one second while I blow my nose. And we're back. Okay. And Real Engine decided to open up on this monitor for some reason. Yep. So we create a new test level. It'll just be a basic test level for now. We can place the level setup helper here. Generate a 32 by 32 grid with a tile period of 300. And all of a sudden we got... Sorry, and suddenly we got the map. Now we can place the various pieces into the level and give them spot number one default, okay. And the coordinates already is set for us, but yeah, and it's alive. We start alive. Really, alive is not going to be doing much for the game itself. It's just going to be a quick state. If we need to kill off a piece and run the AI before the game can actually dispose of the actor, but you know. I could have also set the coordinate to -1, -1 or something like that, but you know, an extra variable wouldn't really hurt that much. Well, theoretically, it could add bugs, but you know. And we were also last time working on getting a lighting profile into it. I can actually show you that level. Where it's gonna be somewhat similar to the art style we're gonna expect. So this is the gold team material. And a tile. In a properly lit room, which is using the Epic's front yard, but you know. We'll use a different one later. So anyway. We have that. Now we're going to work on player tick. Yep. So let's open up Visual Studio Code. And see our previous version of the player controller. So I'm trying to think of what would be the best way to do it. One of the ways that JavaScript JS lint, which is not necessarily the... it's kind of the popular way of doing it just because the guy has a book, but not really in practice. People are like, yeah, we use something else. They actually made a tool to modify their design pattern. But one thing that's one of their design patterns that people kind of stick with, I'm not sure why, but it's to do all your defines at the top and then modify them within, and that's so you can, you know, see at a glance at the start of a function what all the data is that the method is going to be using. I'm not sure if that's really a good design pattern to use for this, so actually, as a matter of fact, we get a couple of seconds. We can, probably going to be a longer stream today, at least that's what I'm planning. Let's actually look at Unreal Tournament. So GitHub Unreal Tournament Oh, that's what I want. Need to sign in, so it'll be 1 second. Yes, yes, yes. No, I don't want to remember that. There we are. Okay, so let's see what their design patterns are. Oh, I guess UT armor doesn't have a tick. I guess that makes sense. So UT character would probably have tick. Actually, player controller. Let's do player controller. UT player controller. Now look for player tick. Okay, so state name is that, get pawn is null, or so they kind of just create things as they go along. Okay. Figured that was kind of the way of people doing it, but you know. Okay, so here we are, then we got current time up there. So then we got cancel pressed. Then pragma region, handle. Play input if B cancel pressed deselect. So I'll need to create a function for deselect before it'll compile again. I had deselect location earlier, but I'm gonna change that to deselect more of a general sense. Because I may want to have more than one thing be deselected. And I'll have all the states, so it would be call deselect, and it would call the functions that would need to deselect whatever I need to. So maybe deselect cards, maybe deselect locations, or whatever, right? Okay. So we'll do if is player turn, and this will be where we do all the selection stuff. So what I had here was if B action press and B mouse pressed, and is selection made as mouse press, That's a bit confusing for what I'm trying to do. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to say that if the user wants to create an action on this hovered state, It was a bit easier to first check it because I was able to just use click events, right? But now I need to actually program the I just want to make sure I didn't have my password copy pasted. For GitHub, that is. So I'm going to try to re-implement what onClick is from the perspective of the mouse cursor, basically. Alright, so this is what I can do. Yeah, let's actually do it like this. So, if the action pressed, we'll have a bool be action required equals false. If B action pressed, B action required equals true. If B mouse pressed, so we'll have this region be, not region, but have this block be, check to see if user is submitting an action. Check if action button or double click or double select mouse double select. If B mouse pressed, F hit result hits, get hit result under cursor by channel, because we have to use by channel now. It'll be giving us an actor. But we don't know what that actor is. The actor could be a static mesh in a world, which case is useless to us. It could be the skybox, which is useless to us. It could be a piece that's not useless to us. We can get a location from that. It could also be a tile that's not useless for us. We can get a location off the tile, right? So basically what we're doing is we're doing an on-click event on the tile or on the piece, but we're doing it from the perspective of the mouse cursor. So we say we're clicking on something, tracing the world in our mouse cursor, what are we clicking on, and pretend that has an on-click event based on that, right? Kind of, yeah. So if selected actor, so if there is no actor, just skip this entirely because who cares? If selected actor is a piece static class, so that's a piece or any of its children. I don't have a piece here. I'm gonna need tile.h2. Tile.h, not g. So if it's a piece, then we'll do a piece selected piece equals cast a piece selected actor current location. Oh, I didn't include current location. Okay. That's what I need to do. F int vector current location equals selected piece. And what did I have for that? I don't think I created that. No, I have to do piece state. Okay. Dot coordinate. The current coordinate, actually, which means in base player controller we're gonna have, instead of selected location and hover location, we're gonna have coordinate and hover coordinate, just because a coordinate is a bit easier to separate mentally from a world location, which is an actual value in centimeters in the actual world itself. I don't want to confuse myself and think, is this function mine or is this function Epic's, right? If it's coordinate, there's nothing Unreal Engine does in coordinate system. I created the coordinate system, so that's fine. Location, now they usually use position, but location, position could be easy to confuse. Coordinate, not so much. If current coordinate equals hovered coordinate, B action required equals true. So I'm gonna be flipping this state for action pressed if I select a piece or if I select a tile. And why aren't they seeing a piece? Hey, what's your wood? What's up? Welcome to the chat. Oh, pice. Piece, there we are. Uh, selected actor. F int vector current coordinates equals selected tile. Tile state dot coordinate. At some point, I'm going to want to add a function on selected tile, or on a piece and tile, well, a piece a tile for returning the coordinate on the state that it has. What am I scripting? Okay, show it again. So, you see, this looks like a chess game, but it's not quite. So, let's look at a chessboard. I can move my piece forward, only one spot though, and I can move to the side. And then I can move the queen up, and that's fine. And then it wants to move, and I can move the queen to kill it, or I can move my pawn and kill it in any of the diagonals. So let's kill it with a pawn. And then we can move the queen and so forth. That's fine. We can also do a different level though. Let's do cross streams, which is a bit larger than a chessboard. So this is a 64 by 64 grid. The AI spawns over here. The player spawns over here. And then you can choose to move your king over to get these knights within control range. To select them. So in this case, it's going to be, this one's going to be in range, so I can move it, or I can select this, but it won't, it's not in range, so I can't control it. So I can move this one, but I can't move that one. Or I can move the king over further to move the king out, the other knight out, I mean. And so forth, and there's gaps, there's corridors. And meanwhile, the AI, if it wasn't dumb, actually, no, it's acting pretty good right now. Is going to try to move into town to get a good position on us. But I mean, I said the AI was bad. It was even known to, like, despawn its own pieces. Not, like, have them captured. I mean, like, have them vanish. I never actually found what happened to the queen. So, yeah, it's not a good idea for that. But, yeah, so we then had a remake of it. A remake of it, which was broken when we changed it to Unreal Engine 4.12. So we kind of are fixing it right now. We're going to be kind of piling in the amount of work we need to get it fixed. But this is what it ended up being like before we had to fix it. This is a splash screen. I'm gonna host a game. I'll create one versus AI. How much is all this software? The software I'm using? So Photoshop is part of Creative Cloud. But Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio 2015 Community, Unreal Engine 4, OBS, so I'm using the stream. Windows Media Player, I'm using the stream. All of that is free. So, a lot of it's free. As a matter of fact, I should probably check an Epic Launcher to see if there's a new engine version. No, okay. So this is the slightly more fixed version. We were working on AI when we stopped. And it decided to kill my king, which is fine because I have a second king over here. Yeah, free stuff can be nice. Yeah, killed my knight, and that's fine, because I'm going to be coming for it. AI was set in this version before the fix to if it sees anything that I can take a favorable trade on to kill it. Otherwise, oh, for some reason it's choosing to not move. Weird. Otherwise, make a random move. Okay, that one I can see why I did that. Can't do it in one. And then here. And then die. And now it has no king. It can't. The game's technically won, but it can't fight back even if it wanted to. So I'm just gonna kill everything there. And we just killed everything on the level. Yay! Playing Dark Extension on one screen with me on the other. Nice. Which screen's Game of Thrones on? Or is it actually not? I never even know what time HBO plays Game of Thrones. Is it now or is it in like 15 minutes? I've never watched it, so. But I know a lot of people like it, to say the least. Waiting. There we are. So, if current coordinate. So right now, what I'm working on is the player camera control. You don't know you don't watch that crap. Okay, so Mir's gonna watch binge on when the season finishes. That's cool. The reason why I asked is because I think it was Mir who said that. I shouldn't stream around this time because it would conflict with Game of Thrones. So if the mouse is pressed and we select a piece or a tile, and that piece or a tile's coordinate is what we're hovered on, then select true. Also, you don't have HBO. Okay. HBO is a home box office. It's a cable channel, mostly in the States. Yeah, the one that shows Game of Thrones. They're known to be a bit on the whatever they can get away with side. So how it works in the States is that the FCC decided that I could censor what's broadcasted over the airwaves, and if things like, you know, the NFL, you know, wardrobe malfunction or whatever gets displayed, then they have the right to fine the stations for using their spectrum for whatever. but you can't actually censor speech itself. So when cable started going around actually connecting cable from the door-to-door, that's not over the air, that's not under FCC's, well, I mean, it's under FCC's control, but not exactly the same way. Like you have the cable emit EM radiation that jams whatever, but you know what I mean. So we started having some cable companies, HBO being the main one, but also AMC and stuff, start pushing content that really wouldn't pass the censors on over-the-air broadcasts. So they started making niches. But yeah, and I mean, there is some debate whether they should be, you know, censoring that stuff anyway, but that's not entirely my discussion right now. Okay, so what I need to do is player turn and deselect. I'm just gonna actually, you know what, for now, I'm gonna add a, helper functions. New gameplay functions. Bool is player turn. And then gameplay so gameplay actions and gameplay checks, let's call it for that for now, and then we'll have void deselect. And we'll add these to our C++ class. So that way they will at least compile, right? We'll actually have this player turn return true all the time. Because we don't have any turns yet, might as well, you know. HBO is in the UK. In Canada, most HBO content goes under the branding of the movie network, but they do have HBO Canada now as well. Turn true, and we'll do implement when we have turns. And then deselect to do that should be self-explanatory. I want to have a deselect function. What do I do? Well, it's an empty function. Yeah, so one of the things with HBO is that's a premium cable channel, so they charge you, I don't know, it's like $30 a month or whatever it is for the channel, of which they get like $8 a month or $9 a month. No, $8, yeah. It was $8 a month, because when Netflix came out, Netflix was doing something similar, and people were like, how can Netflix do what HBO did when HBO is charging $30 a month and they're charging $9 a month? Turns out HBO only got $8 of it, the rest went to the cable company. So they're actually making a bit more, even though they have infrastructure costs and stuff like that. It's not free to make Netflix. But yeah. Turns out they're getting $1 more than HBO did, just because of the way the old media was set up. At least that's what Brian Brushwood, I think it was, said, but. Anyway. Okay, so now we got B action required, so this is if we have a, there. So we will create a int vector action coordinate equals f int vector -1, -1, 0. That should be good. And then the constructor here. Oh, I'm one low. Oh no, I was pressed. That was right. And if player turn check, and then priority and handle gameplay inputs. I don't know what I was thinking before. And if it's player turn block. Okay. So, if B action required, action coordinate. Equals, hovered coordinate. Actually, we need to do that. Because if action is required, it's always going to have to be hovered coordinate. So I don't need to copy that. That just wasted money. Wasted memory, is what I'm trying to say. So I just need to make sure B action required is still true. So if B action required, now we're gonna have to work on this. So so if action required, then we will select the location. I'll try select location. And that's actually moving around. Okay. This is actually not as bad spaghetti hose as I thought the first time. It felt really nasty when I was working on it, but... So if B action required, we will do... attempt to select location. Yeah, let's actually like call it something. Let's call do process hovered coordinate. This is obviously not a void process hovered coordinate. So process hover coordinate's gonna have the chunk of crap that we had floating through here. And that's it. So then we will do pragmat region here. Don't get scripting with all the colons and brackets and stuff. Okay, so this is gonna be kind of syntax, but the context of the curly breaks in C++ is it kind of contains chunks. So you have typically a control statement, and then it says evaluate this entire chunk as if it was in that control statement. So in this case, here it's if bAction required. So it's saying if this boolean is true, which it's going to be true if it's set true here, it's set true here, or it's set true here, otherwise it's going to be false by this point because it's defined as false unless we change it to true. So this here says if true, if it's been changed there, it will be true. So it's going to evaluate this entire block if this is true. There is another way of C++ doing it. I don't really use it that much. If you don't have a block of instructions, if you only have one instruction, you can have it. I think it's just a line below, but let's see. So C++ single line if. There we are. Here it is. So yeah, if you wanted to, you didn't actually need to do like this chunk here. You don't actually need to have curly braces. It's just if you have multiple statements in a row, C++ will actually evaluate this correctly the same way. But if we had, for example, J++ and then some function that uses I and some function uses J and a bunch of other statements, this wouldn't be valid because, you know. So the way the compiler works is it does this, evaluates good, evaluates this. This is a control statement, evaluate here. So this is an if statement, okay, still control statement, evaluate here. And then I'll run, and then I'll be done with a block because it was just one instruction to make it. So basically, control, like curly braces basically say evaluate this entire chunk as if it was one line hanging underneath the control statement. It's a way of allowing multiple statements to occur as if it was directly under if or directly under for. Or directly under do, or directly under while, or directly under try, or directly under catch, or directly under whatever, right? And then there's other ways of people doing it too. Some people do, instead of the curly brace here, they find it looks better like this to make it more clear it's all one line. I don't really like that style, even though it's very common in JavaScript, which is kind of my main language. But yeah, it's just basically a way of saying all of this, like treat it as one line, even though it's multiple instructions inside. So if there's a control statement above it, it'll say all of this belongs to you. I think that's the best way of describing it. Maybe Mir could, or someone else in here could, again, I don't say people's names unless they talk in chat, so I'm not gonna, you know, out the lurkers, right? But if anyone else wants to say a better thing in chat, maybe they can have a better definition or a better explanation than me. Okay. So this will be a function that, that will handle what to do with it. So when we do process hover coordinate, what we might want to do is we might want to have that be our selected coordinate. So if we're moving around the level, we might want to have, if we click on something, move the camera there. On the other hand, we might want to select the piece that's in it, right? So if we want to select, like, let's say there's a queen in that space, we'll select it and we'll see, is it a queen there? Oh, it's queen. Now we're going to, whatever our next action is going to do, it's going to be based on that queen, unless we click cancel, in which case we'll deselect the queen, right? But I'm not going to actually implement it just yet. And why is it still having an error? Oh, it's like a coordinate. There we are. Okay, so that's end of that. Now our next selection is going to be pragma region mouse hovering and region. Hover location. Hover coordinate. I could have all of these combined and just have select hover coordinates one region, but and then have like, you know, a comment for mouse starts here, you know, whatever. But I'm thinking I'm gonna make them different regions. In case I wanna work on one but not the other, I don't have to have them all open. Yeah, sure, let's do it like that. Okay. So again, this is not exactly, the main problem with this is we're not actually working on a click. What we're doing is we're doing a push down, we can drag across, and when we release, then it would change the Boolean. So the problem is we might select multiple things in a single press. People are saying no wub wubs, but there actually is. Is it just too quiet? It's a quiet song. Anyway. This is a really quiet song. Okay. Actually, let's see if there's a way we can handle direct clicks itself. Process a click from a down, mouse down, and mouse up event. Because these are things that usually, actually, let's see over here. So, player controller click. Action. UE4. This would be a good time for me to, because a lot of what I'm doing is I have a boolean that detects when an action happens, flips, and gets reset when I release it. That's one way of doing a click, but it doesn't control like how quick much I click down. This is in C++. Since you're, yeah, okay, hell. I was gonna say, since you're new, I can show you the what we're working on right now, but yeah. Because click events are on the objects, I don't want that to happen, so UE4 mouse interface, okay. So you got mouse interaction. Because what I could do is have the actors themselves respect being clicked, but that's not done from a player controller's perspective, that's done from the object's perspective, which is more useful for single player games. Because I'd have to then, from the actor, say who clicked me, and then act from there, but, you know. Like, it'd be a bit difficult if you have listen servers with more than one player, especially. All right, see you, Westerwood. Thanks for watching the stream. You know what? Let's keep doing this. So, or one thing I could do is, see if the mouse down and mouse up occurs in the same actor. That would be from the player controller perspective. But that would be a bit difficult if there's a bunch of, like, if the piece is on a tile, if they start in a piece and end in a tile, right? But it would allow us to do more things with the mouse cursor. So if I want to like have a drag and pull functionality, I could do that. This is a good time to do these decisions, right? So because we haven't really made anything yet. So we get a mouse down event. We get a mouse up event. Yeah, let's do it like that. So let's change our method. So mouse press is true, and then we will have so register that mouse is still held, and then we will start clicking on object. So f int vector mouse down coordinate. So we will then have this chunk here. Let's actually call it mouse down. Or mouse press. Which we will rebind here. Actually pressed and released. Have consistent grammar. What's this again? Handles clicks. So instead of doing a B mouse selection, made us coordinate. Holding mouse button. Register mouse button. Register mouse button held, and then register mouse button released. Set up for mouse released. Check of clicking on an actor. So we're going to register the actor, and we're going to say if the actor is the same actor, well, at the same coordinates. So if I click on a tile and release on the piece, if the tile and the piece are the same coordinate because the piece is on a tile, then that would be fine. But if I start clicking on the piece and then move to another tile and release there, that won't work. So it doesn't have to be the same actor. It doesn't have to be the same actor because the tile and the piece are different actors, but they're the same location. And I only care about the location, right? I want to register the location. A very wordy way of redundantly saying what I need to, but why not, right? So here it will be mouse down coordinate, and then it will be mouse down coordinate. Acquire location or a coordinate of mouse down. Acquire a game board coordinate. Yep, see ya. Thanks for watching, Woodsterwood. And then on mouse released. Here. If mouse down coordinate equals select piece of coordinate, then if mouse down coordinate equals here, check if mouse up occurred on same game board coordinate as mouse down. I'll do mouse up as one word and mouse down as one word because that's kind of how I'm used to it in JavaScript. That's the typical web events. So now if this is the same as that, we know that they're clicking on the same location. It could be clicking on the piece and releasing a tile, or clicking on a tile, releasing a piece, or clicking on the piece, releasing the piece, clicking on a tile, releasing a tile, but it's the same coordinate regardless. Move hovered to mouse down coordinate. Move hovered coordinate. Mouse down coordinate. And I know I didn't spell it right, or use the same grammar, I should say. Coordinates. There we are. Void move hovered coordinate. And then I can have this over here. Oops, no, I don't want that. One here. Actually, I should check here as well to make sure that Epic. Actions, i.e., press and I released a fire only once. UE4 mouse down event. Because in JavaScript, it can happen many times. You're welcome. Yeah, let's assume we're right. There we are. All right. Oh, that's not right. F and vector. New hover. That's right, coordinate. I mean, you can kind of tell as well. I was saying it's not quite sure if it's an epic method or if it's my method. If I'm using fn vectors, it's probably my method because epic doesn't use that data type basically ever, but you know. So move hover the coordinate. If coordinate dot x is greater than or equal to 0 and coordinate.y is greater than equal to 0. So our hover coordinate equals mouse down coordinate. Oh, equals coordinate, sorry. And then here I can have a mouse down coordinate. Dot x equals -1. Mouse down coordinate dot y equals -1. So we just reset it. Or actually, no, I have mouse down coordinate equals fn vector. -1, -1, 0. Okay, so let's press it, cast press. And we'll have up here rates and things float. Covered change time. And then, so hover change time there. No, that's not what I want. Animation times, float hovered, change time, and this will be move speed first, float move what do I even call it here? Snap delay is what it was. Initial snap delay. Actually, we'll do snap delay initial. Snap. Okay, whatever. Camera. Camera snap delay subsequent. There we are. So hover change time will be the time in seconds. Hover change time equals get world get time. Seconds. Not get world or to get world. Camera snap delay initial equals 0.25. So it was 250 milliseconds. This is in seconds. Camera snap delay subsequent equals 0.15F. I noticed I made a mistake here. I wanted 0.15F, not 0.15. Because that requires, I mean, it's a small issue. It would, if I understand C++ correctly, apply a double precision 0.15 to it and then cast it down as a float, which will reduce precision and require a casting operation, which slows down a little bit. You'd think that a compiler would be smart enough to, you know, undo that, but, you know. Oh, I forgot clamor clockwise intensity. here. Okie dokie, so, oh, did I make a mistake here? Yeah, I made a mistake. Click on coordinate. Mouse down coordinate. I don't want to move hovered coordinate yet, I just want to click on the coordinate. Nope. Void click on coordinate F int vector coordinate. Okie dokie. Yeah, let's have it be like that, okay. Because it could be a hovered event, or it could be selecting the hovered event, so double selecting it, right? So here. So here we saw if the selection is the same as down as up. If the location is the same down as up, now our coordinate is. Now we're going to see if the the clicked coordinate is the same as our hovered or not, right? It's the same as our selected or not. No, it's the same as hovered, sorry. Process hover coordinate. Oh yeah, right there. Okay. And it's doesn't equal. It's a lot of spaghetti code just to move the hover coordinate around, but it's better. Okay, so let's have it, instead of being B action press B, have it B action require. What a sigh. Let's do action required. Here. Then we will get rid of this chunk here because it's already in here. We'll also get rid of this chunk here because that's not the case here. And then we will just have this be a null up. Action required is true. So for clicking on the hover to coordinate, we need an action on that coordinate. Otherwise, we want to move to that coordinate. We want to move our hover there. Now in here I can set up the process hover coordinates. So then process hover coordinate will be the one that handles whether I want to select or whether I want to do something with my selection. So this opens up the possibility for us to do like click and drag to move the game world around. Like let's say we want to do peak, we can without moving hover, we can select if we want to do that. That's not something we're going to implement right yet, but it would give us options to do stuff other than click on things, because we'll actually be handling with a real click event. Process hover coordinates is what we have to do next. Mouse selecting, I think we've already implemented. I generally speaking don't like adding this stuff to other functions, particularly functions we bind to events. I prefer to flip booleans and then check in a tick function, but that's me, I guess. So mouse select hover coordinate, we don't need to do that anymore. We do have to control our selection now. So we need to do move hover coordinate. Boolean B first animation or first animation, yeah. Or are we making it harder for ourselves? Trying to fix the bugs we had earlier, but it's just making it even more complicated. Okay, so here, F int vector, get, gamepad, get joystick, or thumbstick, get stick direction. Oh, I have a player orientation into it too. Okay, so we fixed the click system. Why is that not okay? We know that works, so that's fine. Most is handled by click event or click methods, but this will be for our gamepad. And we got current time already, okay. Oh, that's what I can do. Time, camera, move, finish. And instead of this being here, we will have this chunk here. Time, camera, move, finish. Equals get real good for 5 seconds. Plus camera snap delay initial. There we are. So pragma region controller movements and region. So if current time is less than or greater than or equal to time camera move finish. Where's the last location again? Oh, last location is something I said as well. F int vector previous hovered coordinate. There we are. Let's go back down here. Previous hovered coordinate equals hovered coordinate. Just copy and paste this directly. Get selected direction, what did I call it? Get stick direction. There we are. Hover location and stuff like that's fine. hovered coordinates. That's just a chunk to make sure I don't go out of bounds. Or rather, if I try to go out of bounds, to snap it to the bounds. And I get the game states here, but game state doesn't have that. Game state has, nothing right now. I didn't want to do dimensions. Oh, by the way, one thing I didn't really say is that as was working the last time, even though it never actually came up, the hovered location can be any tile, even if a tile is disabled. That's kind of my way of allowing you to, move to, let's say there's a tile on the middle of a wall. You can still move to it and have the camera snap on it, but it won't do anything. I'd probably end up having an aura animation occur of like, this is not a valid tile, but here you are, right? Here's a camera. I'm just concerned about the bounds. And the reason for that is because, let's say I have a river, like in cross streams, I don't want to have to make the player move to a bridge, go up the bridge and move back to where they want to. Like, I want them to be able to just, you know, go across the river, right? And if there's no tile between there, well, have the camera hover to someplace that's not valid, right? It's not selecting, it's just moving the camera there, so it's fine. Isn't that something I'm gonna want to do anyway? Here. As a matter of fact, it's not even what I want to do anyway. Let's try a little step helper, see if that helps. Mm. Now we'll just make sure that GameState has level dimensions. Sure, why not? Why not? F and vector level dimensions. So get tile coordinate, let's comment this out. And I need to do this start as well because I may have, because I have different animation times. So then here,
will we ever get off this island?
Previous hover coordinate. Hover coordinates. There we are. Now we reconciled both of these. I just realized something. I realized that if I have the gamepad selecting a invisible tile that's over a river or something, that's fine. I can move there, but there'd be no way for me to click on it because it's not drawn, right? So I'd probably need to have the aura always visible at all times to allow me to click on tiles that are over a river or something. Which means I probably have to have a material for a tile that's over middle of nowhere. And do so in a way it's not confusing. That's not a bug that was introduced right now, it's a bug that was introduced in the last revision we had, but you know. It was a lot easier when we were just dealing with the first check it, where we were just moving our camera around and it was just moving the pawn around the world. It wasn't attached to any given tile, although that would make selecting more difficult, right? Because I have to click on them. Interesting how you have two trade-offs of makes one way more difficult, one way more easy, right? Actually, now I think of it, No, it's fine. What I was thinking of is, the way we had originally is if you click on something, the, distance of it would make the animation last longer. But, I mean, if you're clicking on something and it happens the same speed, it doesn't matter the distance for it, you're wanting to go there immediately, so should be fine. I'm not gonna want these, I'm gonna have different ways of doing this, but when it comes to actually changing the animation, the auras and the animations on the tiles themselves. So I'm just gonna keep them commented out. And now we need to actually implement the camera move, so pragma region, animate camera movement. Pragma end region. So I'm going to need to, implement get tile coordinate on this. That's okay. Pragma region animate camera. Camera rotation. And then here, paste that. That's stuff that we haven't really done yet, but that's okay. Pragma region. Animate camera zoom. Pragma end region. So these things I haven't done yet. And that's the end of that. Okay. So now we need to re-implement these things. And it's already 11:15. Alright. Tile accessors. A tile get tile at coordinates. F int vector coordinate. That should be good for now. They will add a definition for that. Not there in there. I mean, they're the same spot, but, you know. This is something that's very easy to write, but if I can just copy and paste it, why not? So is this doing stuff out to the log if I have a misconfigured level? So level tiles. Oh, I didn't include a... There. And it would be... not that, it would be tile.h, tile state. There we are. Isn't this Variant song? Yeah, from Variant Supercell. Featuring Vila. Okay. Okay. And then I should actually do first move animation. Seeing any errors. Yeah, there we are. I'm gonna say I'm not seeing any errors yet. Location hover location is undefined. So it's a previous hover the coordinate. And hover coordinate. Then here I had desired yaw as well for that, so I'll leave that though. Float time camera rotate or finish. I only need start because there's only gonna be one rotation time. This and this is because when you're moving around the map, the first move in a direction is gonna be quick or slower than the second and third and fourth movement. And the idea for that is for some acceleration. So if you wanted to move one tile over, you have more of a chance to let go of the thumbstick without slowing down, keep going in that direction. So boom, 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 right? Versus just, you know, boom, 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 or boom, oh, crap, I missed it, right? Or boom, boom, you know, crap, I missed it, right? Whatever, you know what I mean? You know what I mean. Time camera rotate fish. Fishing. So a desired yaw and last yaw. Animation values. Float desired yaw. Float last yaw. I look pucker go sleep. Nope, not yet. No nap. What was I looking for again? Oh, camera rotate delay. First move animation. And float, camera, zoom speed, float, camera, zoom in, float camera, zoom max. I know this isn't, it's complaining because it's, not seeing the same thing, but yeah. Oh, did I have a zoom level as well? Oh no, it's there. It's a local variable. Okay. Load camera, click, clock, click, zoom, right. I'll do analog. Then rate to make it the same. Zoom rate. there, zoom in a bit, and there we are. So I'm gonna move up here, and then we'll see what we have there. So, and delay here. Camera, oh, not camera, okay. Camera, click, zoom, rates equals 200.f, so 200 per click, so camera analog zoom rates is zoom speed, so f. That's just copying what I had earlier. Camera min, sorry, zoom min equals 600.f. Camera, camera zoom max equals 1600.f. And then B first animation, move animation equals true. That should be good, unless I get a bug, which I'm gonna get a bug because this is a lot of code to add at once. A lot of it's copy and pasted, but, you know. Sorry, to-do. To-do is stuff I haven't done yet. Fix me stuff that I've done and didn't actually do. Or is broken some way. Anyway, to-do, modify tile materials. Yeah, it'd be kind of hard to use a function on variables that don't exist. Just saying. okay. So this still won't work yet because we don't... maybe it will. No, it still won't work yet because we haven't added the tiles to the game state on game launch. But that's a simple fix. The problem is, in order for us to do that, we have to make game mode. So as soon as we try to do anything, it's going to crash because it's a null pointer. But, yeah, other than that, it should be, done reasonably well. And over here, process hover location, as in perform action there. They say don't comment bad code, fix bad code, but I mean, I think that's the best I can do. Animate camera zoom. It'd be good to know the load order of Unreal Engine. Objects, actors. Game mode, game state, player state, level, HUD, player, player pawn. I guess so. Actually, I guess that would matter because it depends on whether you're joining an existing world or not. Anyway, the point of just doing that was to see when I'd be allowed to access the level tiles. I shouldn't need to access them before I begin play. Do this. Let's actually look on here. So UE4 API game state. So they're constructed. That's weird. Public function virtual, public function virtual, public function. They used to be icons, but they're now showing just the names. Is Epic having a server issue, or am I just... Oh, geez, now it's showing different stuff. Oh, no, here, sorry. Oh, handle match is waiting to start. Oh, okay. I thought Game Mode had to call that, but I guess it has its own event for that. Yeah, okay. That might be, which is what I need. Handle match waited to start. Is waiting to start. Oh, that's interesting.
Huh.
I mean, the easiest way to do it is to, and it's what I'm going to end up having to do anyway at some point is, have my own game state. As we saw in the last attempt, that, because on begin play, it's when everyone spawns into the game, but it's not when I want the game to actually start. So I'm going to have to re-implement that, which is going to be annoying. So we're going to spawn everyone as into the game, spectator or not, and but have the game be later. Because we don't know. Well, I guess we could still do the game's time, like, for that. Because we don't know how long it takes for people to join in the game, right? The game starts when Unreal Engine says the players are connected to the game, but if not everyone has started, then I can't start the actual game and let people play. Although I guess I could just have the people spawn in where they need to and just have, you know, wait until that turn occurs or whatever. That's interesting to think about, but anyway. But yeah, for here, I didn't realize the game state had this overridable method though, so I'm losing my mind here. Virtual void, there we are. Virtual void, handle match is waiting to start. Override. And then over here, let's actually just add the declaration to it. See if IntelliSense does the right thing. Okay, sure. And then here, handle matches waiting to start, we will do come on. Oh, okay, the multicast here, they are. Okay. So when it's not level manager, it's level setup helper now. Include level. Level setup helper dot h. There we are. Level setup helper. Level manager. Level dimensions is that, which is that there. Then we will have oh, okay. And then Wow, that's okay. So this is a big chunk of code that sets the team colors, apparently. Oh no, we don't need to do all that yet. Yeah, that's stuff we don't know yet. So it sets up the tiles, the pieces, and the dimensions. Now let's see if this builds. I got a feeling it won't. Yeah. Thank you very much. Oh, I didn't include tile or piece yet. Oh, I include tile, I didn't include piece. So it builds, okay. So I still got a lot more to do, but let's see what this does when it builds. I know, for example, we don't set the spawn points or anything like that, but I'm just gonna see if it actually works as intended. Oh, actually, what we also need is to, in the project settings here, I'm not sure if we implemented, I think we did the rotation stuff, right? We did clockwise. Oh, we did change some names though, so we're gonna need to adjust that. Oh no, we didn't. We changed the names of the functions, we didn't change the names of what the things are bound to. So I'd actually probably wanna adjust that at some point, but not right now. Okay, so let's create a new level. Once again, we're not saving a level because, you know, it's a test map. We don't want to set up a test map until we know we're good to do it. So our movement mechanic seems to work. Doesn't actually highlight or anything like that, but that's not the point. Zoom in, zoom out, scroll in, scroll out, click, 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 click. Rejected, 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 click, click. Well then, that's surprising. It seems to be working. Okay. Let's commit this and call it a day before we break something. Is this what it's like to be a good programmer? Amazing is what Mir says. Check it. Git add A, git commits M. basic camera controls. Refactor. 20 deletions, 377 insertions, 4 files changed. Well then, can only go down the hill from here, so have a good evening.